May I have a show of hands of all those people who have been to the Lake Forest programs? Welcome home. On the way here, I thought I was home. It just looked like the Midwest. But thanks for doing all the work. And well, we can call this a reunion and welcome new members to the family. Notice the title that Hans made up, Beginnings. I have many beginnings, and I will begin from the very beginning. In 1962, I received a PhD in nuclear physics with a minor in mathematics, of course, but also in education. I knew that whatever I majored in, I want to teach it. And I chose Lake Forest because a friend of mine preceded me there and invited me and my wife in 1962 to visit him. Right then, we knew that's where we wanted to live. I'm still there. We are still there after 43 years. Okay. But there's another reason for them to hire me. I was interested in teaching, and Lake Forest College has a national reputation in developing educational programs for science education. So when we arrived in 1963, my first job, beside teaching and commuting to Oak Ridge National Lab to do nuclear physics, was to write a proposal to the National Science Foundation to do a workshop in 1965 summer on the development of modern physics for undergraduates. So my job was to search subjects so that we can have something to contribute during that workshop. Among the list we made up and subsequently delivered, we converted meaningful experiments for undergraduates, nuclear magnetic resonance, relativistic mass measurements, we did population inversion because that was really new, and many other experiments. But among them, I found the papers by Emmett Leith. And we said, this is worthy of converting to something undergraduates can do. Young undergraduates, second year, before quantum mechanics, we want them to do it and get excited. Then they will want to learn the depth of the subject. That's the philosophy. So I wrote a letter in 1964 to Emmett Leith. By the way, as I said, we got the grant. So I told him about that and want to borrow a hologram. I never seen one. Very quickly, he not only responded to me, he sent me a hologram, the 4x5-inch hologram of the chess set. And he says, keep it. Never knew me. That's my beginning in holography, a beginning of a new life, as a matter of fact. Having seen that hologram, we immediately got a 1 milliwatt laser, $1,000 in 1964. Warranty 3 months. 1 meter long, RF driven. So we wanted to deliver the beginning of the summer of 65, when the workshop is. It quickly died by September, by the way. But long enough for us to develop a new idea on making celestial holograms and publish the paper. And during that workshop, we show people how to make a simple hologram without the granite blocks that Emmett Leith used. So that's another beginning. We made our first hologram. In 1966, we presented the paper on cylindrical hologram in Columbus, Ohio, Optical Society meeting, chaired by Emmett Leith, my first meeting with him. There he introduced to me Gabor. And after the paper, Gabor hired my student, author. He was a freshman for summer assistant my sophomore year. None of us knew holography. We learned together. That's the best way to teach. Because students were teaching me because they thought of something I didn't know. And none of us knew, but we published a paper. And suddenly, when you get a paper published, you get grants, more grants. So we developed more holography. And by 1971, I decided holography is for everyone, not just physicists. For children, for artists. So I ran the first workshop in 1971. Among the first participants were Posey Jackson, Jody Burns. Remember them? The following year, lots of people, Larry Lieberman and so forth. And after, by 1971, we decided, let's do workshops. So that's another beginning. The workshop first was just for beginners, how to make holograms, and only taught by me. But starting then, I decided there are a lot of subjects within holography. I start looking for experts in each field and start having special workshops on interferometry subsequently. In color holography, Hans, of course, come along. And many others, embossing, DCG, and so forth. Each one become its own workshop series. So I'm going to show you 170 slides, 4 seconds each, so that you be in time for coffee break. All these slides will be put on a website, holographer.org. You can download any picture you like, because you'll be see some embarrassing pictures of yourselves. Okay, I have 2 sets of slides, the pre-ISDH and the ISDH. Okay, pre means before 1982. Here Emmett Leith comes in again. He helped me find some of the experts whom I would not have been able to get to teach. So let me start with the very first slide of pre-ISDH, how before our conference began, we had workshops. I'm hoping to get my first picture. Here. Notice the second person from the left. He helped me taught for 4 summers holographic interferometry, along with Niels Abramson and Priputnevich. His name is Charles Vest. In the 4th summer, he came and told me, I didn't know how important he was. He was friend of Emmett Leith and twist his arm to make him come and teach my workshop every year. He said, TJ, next year I'm going to be president of MIT. I can't come anymore. I said, trivial reason. Well, he was president for MIT for 19 years. He taught interferometry. Okay. And now, these are the man in the middle. Let's see, I get back. The man with the folded hand, Hugues Soupary. He's now one of the richest holographers in the world, okay. He's president of Hologram Industries with Coventry in China. He come to everyone, took every course, okay. So I should make him contribute to something, but that's before we had a beautiful beach in Lake Forest. It was being eroded away. We had our picnics above with very primitive equipment. He's blowing the charcoal to get things going. And Ruckheimer on the left, he converted the entire state of Montana. Every high school teach holography. So these are my missionaries. Here's another one. So these are all before. That's Tom Svetkovich. Is he here? He's using a phonograph record player and spin code DCG. Our whole purpose is hands on. Do it. Don't just talk. Okay. And so now, post 1982, I got started in a symposium here. I'm starting the tribute to Emmett Leith and Yuri now, because I don't have time later. Anything I do in holography, I cannot not mention Emmett Leith. I decided to hold an international conference, and it takes funding, as Hans found out here, and you got funding. Emmett Leith wrote a letter to whom it may concern and tell you people must support this program on an international symposium on holography. And I got a $45,000 grant from McDonald's. In the subsequent symposium, McDonald's bussed everybody in the symposium to Hamburger University and fed us hors d'oeuvres and cocktails, no Big Macs. That allowed us to renovate our art department to be, they had tungsten lights. We changed all the light, all the curtains, and it's become a perfect place for art exhibitions. Thanks to Emmett Leith. And he came to every one of my symposia, participated in all of them. So the next 170 slides is a symposium in which I had $45,000 to spend. I hired a photographer to take these pictures. I have never had time to look at it until 5 weeks ago. I went to the lab and digged it up and got it digitized. So here you are. You see a lot of yourselves in it. And now it'd be very quick, long enough for you to decide which one to download when we get it to in holographers.org, okay? So.
You might cut the overhead lights to see the picture.
I haven't finished this yet. But this is Uksu Pari, as I said, he took everything. Oh, I have one more comment. One of my intentions, which did not work out, I do fail a lot, okay? Although you don't hear about it until now. I had intended to teach a workshop on theoretical holography and start with this one equation. That's the fourth space equation of Maxwell's equation. It says the derambition of the fourth space current density and so forth and so forth. Start from that, day one, and derive theoretically everything in holography mathematically. No one wanted to take that workshop. Well, I take it back. One student from Lake Forest College did, and I just did a half-year independent study with him. And I learned a lot, you know, from all the couple wave theory and so forth. It's a great intellectual exercise. You want to do that. Everything in holography, everything comes from that equation, okay? One, the four space vector equation of Maxwell's equation. Anyway, that didn't work. This is not for that one. Yeah, I don't even know I got this picture. It's dug up from the archive in the college. Oh, everybody remember Mrs. Christ? That's my secret weapon. Without her, I would not have had any symposia. He ran all of it single-handedly with two student helps. Okay. And she's still working because our department cannot do without her. We'll all get lost. Now, the second set. These are in color, taken by professional. I think this is during the 1985 symposium, during the grand opening of our exhibition. That's my wife, Carl Lambrecht, Michael Croyton, chairman of the art department, who many of you know him. How many of you know him? Right. He moved to France. He bought a chateau. That's Carl Lambrecht. A family business of digging natural crystals for optics. My right-hand man for many years at Lake Forest College, Ed Wesley. Too bad he couldn't make it. He got fouled up with his passport problems. Shout out the name when you see people, okay? John Kaufman, and of course, no introduction needed. So as I go, if you see somebody, everybody ought to know, shout out the name, participate. Very quick. Hey, Richard Brooks, he just arrived right there. Yeah, some of them, you see. And at least, he comes to everything. All of them attends every session.
Walker.
Right.
Oh my God.
Okay. Glenda Law. She was the art director for that one. And subsequently, Melissa Crenshaw, Sydney Densmore, and Tom. Mm-hmm. Second from the left is my first son, Alan. He helps out. This is our art department. We stand here and later always have a group portrait, as we will do today. Several shots of this. If you dwell, you will find lots of people. There's Neil Abrams right in the middle, and Linda Law and others. And always Steve Smith direct the traffic here, take the photographs, later make stereograms. I'm going to donate a 1994 stereogram in four colors, people waving. And it's an inside cover of the proceedings published by SBIE. Who's the lady?
Heidi
Kaufman. Water clock. Now that reminds me. I can claim, because I witnessed with my own eyes, he met his future wife right in my symposium there. He married Eve, lived in, last I know, in Israel.
Mm-hmm.
They've been talking a long time. This is the second picture of them. Oh, look at that. That's Mrs. Virginia Christ again. Ron Erickson, he was my student. In fact, let me tell you another pre-beginning. The year before I ran my first workshop, which quiet, not at home in somebody else's house, Ron Erickson here, my senior student then, we ran a holography workshop downtown Chicago in Columbia College, which was in one wooden house. Right now, it's a beautiful, large downtown college now. And in that wooden house, every time somebody moves, the whole building shakes. So we made a rule, whenever somebody makes an exposure, we blow a loud horn, beep, everybody in the building, freeze, don't move. After the exposure, beep, beep, everybody moved again. And it worked. So we start the next year our own workshop. Who's the guy next to Hugh? Tom? Ron. Are you singing a duet or something? This is inside the exhibition. It's a beautiful building with the wooden structures.
Steve Smith.
Steve Smith. Is your girl Ishii? Who is the lady on the right? I think her name was Beata from Australia. I find later, Mrs. Chris told me. Now, this is not meant to embarrass her. It's a very public fact, okay? She couldn't pay the registration fee until afterwards. And Mrs. Chris found out that her check was from a new dancing club in Chicago. You can see that she would perform well. So we have every kind of talent among the holography community. Christakis, Paris, right? Niels Abramson on the right. Niels is all over the place. He even stay and windsurf with me. He keeps his windsurfing machine still in my lake house. So if he ever go to Lake Forest, he's got his own equipment. Professor Xu comes to all of them, met him in 1976 in Beijing, and who's this? Mm-hmm. Oh, this is a significant picture. Teacher and pupil. Some of you may not know, Hans received his PhD from Niels. So Hans, I feel like a nephew to me. Niels is my age. Oh, there's Jeff Blythe. Now, who is this in the kimono? Anybody remember? I remember she got sick and had to go to the hospital, but she was okay then. But it's very colorful because we decided to have a formal opening, and some people dress up. This is McShane. He's a teacher in the Chicago area, very active. They're all looking at the exhibition. Somehow, my photographer is very attracted to Carl Lambrecht. He has an office in Moscow, so he's the one who introduced me to Moscow in 1976. I stay in his place. Steve Benton shaking hands with Michael Creighton, and right. Mm-hmm. You can see some of the holograms behind. Now, everybody's looking down. I'm going to show you another picture. Why? Oh, there's all right. There are a lot of holograms on the tabletop. I think this was a hologram of a sort of a three-dimensional chess set. Sally Weber. Louis Kotnick, a lawyer who started with in Lancaster, the Holography News. Edwina? Steve Smith and his prolific family. Oops. As I said, Steve Smith, prolific. You know, Margaret. That's my student. He has a company doing holographic inspections. Craig's here, right? Yeah, New Swing.
That's Mike Titel on the right.
Oh, right. Oh, here's Saxby in his introduction to his book. He learned everything he knows about holography from meeting people there, almost, right? So he's...
TJ, there's not very much gray hair in those days.
Right. Big Mike. Beside anything else, he's also a bodyguard, you know why. Oh, my sister-in-law is there. I didn't know she was there. By the way, I have not looked at this. I just found them a few weeks ago. And I said, let's show them all.
Is
Haberman, yeah. Ed Dietrich. He taught holography at the School of Art Institute for a while. Cosette. No. Marie-Andre Cosette. Oh, here's a piece, I got a story to tell. We received a box for the exhibition and everything inside was broken. Insured for $10,000, which we are in trouble. We opened it, that is the exhibition, a broken window. By Al Rizzuto. So here's the window, here's a shot on the floor, they're all holograms, a window with memories. As Steve Benton would say, a hologram is. Okay. And this, I think, is a very nice piece. Everybody look at it a lot. Oh, some of this are double. Oh, here's another. I sent this to our college archive, and the staff converted, digitized it for me. I'm waiting for one, my favorite, I'll show you when it comes up. Some of these have different shots of the same thing. Such a ghost here. Having a good time? That's my father-in-law. He died at age 97, some years ago, but he wrote a column in Chinese and published in the Toronto Chinese News about this exhibition. And he wrote a book called Pilgrimage, showing his photographs and a hologram of Margaret Benyon's a Thai girl. So that's in the Chinese newspaper, Margaret. Wow. Yeah. Lee Lacy. I know he's alive, but he never showed himself anywhere. He was showing in the dormitory. Oh, remember, I'd like to give some highlights. You are locked in a little town, just like you are now, with nothing to do but to mingle with each other. That's how we form the community, okay? So this is the same concept. But knowing what happened during our exhibition, there's a couple here, humans. They just reminded me a while ago, they met in Lake Forest 15 years ago and got married. So that's number two I know besides Walter Clark and Eve. And I would mention to Hans, we should make a declaration here to everyone. Any outcome of this meeting that's non-holographic, any relationship you form, is not our responsibility. Do not sue us. Again. Oh, I have another group of pictures I'm going to show later during the tribute. There I have other, even more interesting pictures. So I have gone through this round once. Oh, we're still going on. I guess they duplicated more than once. I hand all these slides together. This is our quartet. I played in a symphony orchestra, and I talked these people into playing for free. It's a semi-professional orchestra that I joined since I've been in Lake Forest. And a few got duplicated more than once, but not all. Let me go to... So we converted the live drawing room also, making curtains to cover the sunlight so we can have... there's a Andre Cosette. Now, oh, this, and more woman next to. Oh. Again, some of them got duplicated more than once. Whoa, look at the teeth. Linda Law. Nick Phillip. I could not get into that jacket again, so I'm not wearing it. AJ, right, he taught for many years embossing technology. Mm-hmm. Oh, this is the picture I want to show. Whoop. This is, I would call it Les Grandes Dames de l'Holography. Look at who they are. All right. So that's a really great picture. Many of you should be in it, but this whole group is very important to art holography. There it is. Well, thank you very much. I'll talk more later.